Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is Raja from IIT Madras. I am an MS scholar in the Department of Electrical Engineering at IIT Madras. So I hope you all are doing great and doing good in your life. So this video is all about the Graduate Aptitude Test in Engineering 2024. So in short, as you might have guessed, it is GATE 2024. And this year the organizing institute is IISc Bengaluru. So in this video, I am going to tell you all information concerning the IITM BS Data Science program. So in regard with the IITM BS Data Science program, a very major change has been taken in the GATE 2024. It has been also announced by the IITM director, Professor Kamakwati, in the last paradox. So the new change is that there is an introduction of a new GATE paper, especially designed in the consolation for that IITM BS Data Science program, that is Introduction of Data Science and Artificial Intelligence, that is DA paper. So it is very important to know all about this new paper so that you can prepare well and can secure good marks in it, so that you will be able to use that GATE score later on for your admission in the higher studies. So there are a lot of doubts, especially regarding the eligibility criteria, because in the IITM BS Data Science program, there is no clear-cut distinction between the different years. So in this video, I am going to cover all these questions. And even if you have any other queries, you can ask in the comment section. I will try my best to answer your query. So without wasting your time, let's start the video. So this is the Graduate Aptitude Test in Engineering 2024. The website has been already launched by the IISc Bengaluru. So if you have not visited, I will suggest you please visit the website and read all the section carefully. And once the browser is released, also read that and understand carefully if you are applying for the first time. So if you can see that it is a prestigious national level exam. And apart from that, it is conducting for the total 30 test papers, comprising full and the sectional paper. So one important thing is that it is valid for the 3 years, so that you can use that GATE score later on. And let's come to the eligibility criteria. So here it is clearly written candidates who are studying in the third or higher studies of any undergraduate degree program. So for the IITM BS Data Science program, you can consider like this: foundation level as the first year, or the diploma level as the second year, and the degree level as the third year. And in the degree level, there is a distinction between the BSc and the BS level. So you can consider it like this: if you are in the degree level, you can apply. And if you are not in the degree level, there is actually no use for applying for the exam, because you will be not able to understand or crack the exam, because whatever the concept will be asked in the paper will be mostly related till the diploma. So if you have covered all the diploma subject, both the diploma in data science, diploma in program, then you can appear. And after that, after the completion of the degree program, you can again appear, so that you can increase your GATE score, and that new GATE score you can use the later on for the admission. Even if you appear in the third year, means the third year of program, which means you are in the BSc level, you can apply for the GATE, but you cannot take admission in the M.Tech program, because M.Tech program requires a 4-year bachelor program. So if you are desiring to get admission in the M.Tech, I will suggest you to go till the BS program, so you can use that BS program later for the M.Tech program. So this is all about the BSc program, all about the eligibility criteria. So apart from that, here it is also clearly mentioned for B.Tech and BE, it is clearly clear cut. But for the BS Data Science or BSc program, there is some confusion. And if you see other thing apart from that, other thing which is very important for us is the syllabus. So right now the syllabus has been not declared. So you can see this Data Science Artificial Intelligence, this is a new program. So its syllabus has been not released. but it is more or less similar to the mathematical concept, that is linear algebra, probability, statistics, machine learning program, machine learning and the data, deep learning. So it will revolve around these concepts only. So if you are comfortable in this concept, then you can easily crack the exam. So once the syllabus will be released, you can go through the syllabus and then you can also prepare it accordingly. So since this is the first time, so it might be possible that the paper will be easy, so you can easily score well in the exam. So if you are planning to appear, I will suggest to please appear for the exam. Even if you are in the third year, that is the PSC level, please appear for the exam. Do not think like that I will appear in the final year, that is BS level, and then I will crack. So if you are getting two chances, and so please utilize that. I will suggest strongly for that. Apart from that, another thing which I want to discuss here is that two paper combination. So it is very important. So I will suggest, please, if you are applying for the first time, and if you are applying for the M.Tech program, then I will strongly suggest to appear for the two paper. And for the two paper, you have to select like that you do not have to study very much for the second paper. So if you see that a DA, if you are choosing a DA as a first paper, then you can choose CS, EC, EE, MA, ME, statistics like that. So if you are from the CS background, or if you have some comfortable in the CS subject, I will suggest to go for the CS. Otherwise, you can go for the EE or MA. So if you are not from the engineering background and still if you are want to choose a subject, then I will suggest to go for the MA, that is mathematics. It is more or less inclined towards a DA, so you can use that. So I will suggest you like that. So there is no problem in the two paper. The two paper can be on the same day, or it can be also be on the second, another day. The schedule has not been declared right now, but it will be more or less in the month of February and in the first week or second week of February. So right now you have the 6 months. So if you're planning to appear for this exam, I will suggest to start preparing right now, because this is a very competitive and you have to score a really high. And another thing I want to discuss, that opportunities. It is very important to use your GATE score, because once the GATE, you will give the GATE exam, you will get the GATE score. GATE score and the cutoff and the GATE marks are little bit different. So GATE score is the terms of the 1000. The highest GATE score is the 1000. So if you're getting near to 1000, then it is a good GATE score. So like that. And there's another thing, GATE marks. GATE marks, it is out of 100 generally. So like that, generally the highest marks in a subject, it can be different, but generally it is in the range of the 70 to 90, like that. It can be the highest marks. So, and the cutoff generally, it depends on the subject to subject, but it's generally revolved around the 25, 30, like that. So if you're getting more than cutoff, that you will get the, you will be qualified and you will get the good GATE score. Apart from that, where you can use that GATE score is really matter. And you can use a GATE score in a very optimized manner. So even if you're low GATE score, you can use that and get the admission in the IIT, or you can you can get the admission in the foreign universities also. So a lot of things matters, but you must know all the important things. So a valid GATE score can be used for the master's program, doctoral program. So especially if you are planning, if you have low GATE score, you can use for the doctoral program. So all the doctoral program, that is MS, PhD, require a very low GATE score. After that, if you are prepared for your GATE really well, then you might be clear with your concept. Then you can use that concept to clear the interview. So once you clear the interview, then you will get the admission. So you have to prepare either for the interview really well, or you have to prepare for the GATE exam. So, but you will get the multiple opportunities. So you have to use that multiple opportunities optimally. And apart from that, you will get the financial assistance also. And you can also use the GATE score for the various PSU. But for the PSU, generally a high GATE score is required. So if you have a high GATE score and if your preference for the PSU job sector, then you can use that. Apart from that, you can see the question paper pattern. So if you are new to the GATE, then the question mode will be in English and there will be no Hindi option. You please take care of that. And there will be CBT, just like in the TCS centers, generally it will happen. And it is of 3 hours. And there's an asterisk because it can be varied for the PW students. And the number of subjects is 30. And the section is really matter. For us, for DA section and for engineering papers, there are two sections, general aptitude, that's a GA, and the candidate selected paper. So GA marks is defined, I think. So it is generally of the 15 marks. Yeah, it is written 15 marks. It is fixed. And subject questions will be of 85 marks. So data total will be 100 marks. And the question can be of 1 mark or 2 marks. And similarly, the negative marks can be 1/3 or the 2/3. So there's the negative marks also. So you have to take care of that. Apart from that, the question can be MCQ or MSQ or NAT also. And in MSQ, there is no partial marking. So if you are a peri, if you are the student of IITM BS data science student, so you might be familiar with all this MCQ, NAT, MSQ, because all the questions are just like this only. So this will be not difficult for you. And even the test center will be your TCS center, which you are in which you are appearing for your QGIS and the NSEMs. So like that, you can study about it in more detailed manner. And in the, you can also download the previous papers. So for the DA, there will be no paper, but you can use that mock paper. There will be one mock paper. So they will release a mock paper. So I will suggest you to go through that mock paper as well, because the practice is very important. And then you can go through the FAQs also. There's no much information in this. And this is all about the required documents and the application fees. You can go through that. Right now, you are not required to upload anything. For those categories that you have PSC, ST, or PW certificate, it might be required. And apart from that, you are also required to upload the valid photo identity and your photograph and signature. So please go through it. So the registration will start from the 24 August. It might delay, but more or less it will start from 24 August. And if you are willing to apply, please apply as early as possible, because you will not get the required center if you apply late. So this is all about the GATE 24. So at the last, in conclusion, I can say, if you are IITM BS data science student, and if you are in the degree level, I will suggest you please apply, and you can see how well you are grasping the concept which are taught in the program. So it will really test your grasping concept and intelligence, and it will also provide you a way to get the admission in the highest institutes, higher universities. So if you have any other doubt, you can ask in the comment section. I will be happy. So thank you for watching the video till the end. I will meet you in another video in another day. For then, goodbye. Take care. Happy learning.